There is a revolution happening, a revolution of tyranny, a revolution of evil and hate, but also a revolution of good at the same time. For every action, there's an opposite and equal reaction. As I love to quote, because it's so true to understand this, evil is not the only power in the universe. And its great power is convincing good that good has no power. And really, that's the huge thought beyond an epiphany, because I already knew it. It's a great discovered truth that has not been promoted, that's not been talked about, because for most people, Hollywood, entertainment, what sets the cultural mores, what dominates the thought process, I mean, that is the essence of a culture. And it is a weaponized, criminally directed mafia. I mean, you think you've seen The Sopranos, folks. You ought to actually be in these Hollywood meetings with these top lawyers and owners and producers. I mean, these guys are literally beyond the Godfather. All of them. Big, old, mean men smoking cigarettes and cigars when they're like 80 years old, going, and literally, if you don't start like yelling back at them and telling them, you know, I've sat there and like said, hey, a Texas saying, you know, be careful, drive safe. The guy went, are you threatening me? And he was just totally freaked out. And I was like, no, I'm really serious. And they're like, well, maybe we'll do that deal. Just don't threaten me. And, you know, paranoid, out of their minds. Because everyone else just grovels to them. And all these women out there, particularly, and men, who really think if they could ever get to Hollywood, it's like a bug zapper for women. And they just fly in, me, and it's like, bzz, 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 you know, turning them into hookers, turning them into prostitutes, turning them into, you know, just a system to literally, literally suck this country dry and then export that evil worldwide. And I am investigating it more and more and realizing how this spiritual sickness is being deployed against humanity. They make a documentary about it. I really am intrigued by the mind control machine. Not just the messages that are in it, but how they control the stable of actors, writers, directors, and then how they deploy that. And then how weak it is once you're aware of it and what a fraud it is. And then you see George Clooney for what he is. Not a liberal, but a person selling Obamacare and open borders and disarming the American people when he has bodyguards. Consciously knowing that they're part of a criminal authoritarian takeover and are propaganda officers who willingly embrace it. You know, it's one thing for a lot of the Hollywood stars to just keep their mouth shut or quietly try to do things for liberty. I mean, take Billy Corrigan, you know, 40, 50 million records sold, international star, documentaries, films, whole nine yards. Do you know how much courage it takes for him? Like, I need to call him up. We exchange texts sometimes and talk every once in a while. For him to have come on my show those times and to speak out against the government and to speak out about Obama being a fraud and not saying Republicans are good. He was saying the whole thing's a fraud. I mean, do you understand what happens when people do stuff like that? Do you know? That's why I don't admire Billy Corrigan, even though I'm a fan of a lot of his music, because he's just some famous guy. He's a really nice person. He's a really deep person. He's a really smart person. He's a very genteel person, and he sees past my ogre-likeness and understands that I love beauty and love goodness and love life and creation, and so we resonate on that level. But, I mean, do you know what the type of heat people get just to come on a show that the establishment doesn't want and talk about the weather? They don't like that. That's what the talking points of the White House, the secretive White House, directed into Media Matters every week with weekly meetings as their front. Sure, the site has no visitors, but it's a talking point memo from the White House to see what they think, to see what they say, to see who they don't like. And when you look at things like Media Matters and groups like that, they're there telling Republicans what they can and can't think, and oh my gosh, Rand Paul, don't promote him. No, Ted Cruz, he's a loser. He's a failure when he's exploding and totally successful by challenging the fraud, by calling it out. So they're trying to set reality. They're trying to dictate reality. They are trying to literally create walls in our minds like we're children and telling us Santa Claus is real. That Obamacare cuts your prices down to a phone bill. You can keep your doctor. And I mean, just as they shut down our power plants, as they ship our jobs overseas, cold-bloodedly parading around, oh, that's the high and mighty Obama, the man that loves us. That's the high and mighty Obama, the guy that cares about the children. It's all just a joke. Do you understand how evil Michael Moore is and how evil George Clooney is? Do you realize how fraudulent they are as they do this great evil and then tell us they're high and mighty and they have the moral authority and we've got to do what they say? That is the ultimate form of slavery as they race pimp and create division and try to turn women against men as if men are a bad thing and it's the fault of men that women aren't empowered, so that women are entitled and at war with men and their children instead of at war against the outside elements that are trying to bring down the family. And then men are these arrested development little boys watching simulated combat all day on television and playing video games all day. And so, of course, the women detest it. They want men. They want red-blooded men with guts and big hearts and who are leaders. Of course, women don't even know what they want because no one ever told them. No one ever showed them real role models. From day one, everything's just screw up children, so they have screwed up lives. You think about evil, folks. You think about jacking with the hard wiring of a beautiful species. Bunch of filth, bunch of garbage, bunch of trash enemies. And I see you, you little chicken-necked enemies. Your spirits are about a centimeter high. Your shadow's taller than your soul. And as you go on down that road, you know where you're going. Shadow's taller than your soul. You understand that? You know what that means, don't you? Because I see you, and you need to know that judgment is coming down on all of you. You think you're going to commit these crimes against humanity and not be brought low and not be cut down? You're already cut down. It's why you're so miserable. It's why you're so weak. And it's why you're spiritually shuttered and blind. And the darkness just gets darker and colder by the minute. Because the truth is about hell, it's not hot, it's cold. And you know that coldness now, don't you? You know of what I speak. You know the dark flame you worship. You know you kneel at the altar of death. Because you're afraid of it. You're cowards from the beginning, so you joined with the evil, believing that it would give you power and give you knowledge. All it did was give you knowledge of evil. You think you're masters of evil? You are slaves of evil. My friends, Alex Jones here to tell you about some of the most important information concerning you and your family's health. Radiation levels have more than doubled in the last 60 years in the Northern Hemisphere from all of the nuclear testing and radiological accidents. Radioactive contamination is now in most of the food supply. There's only two ways to avoid this. Move south of the equator or properly protect your thyroid with Nascent Iodine. Looking to protect my family, I've done deep research. Nascent Iodine is the purest, cleanest, absolute best form of iodine to protect yourself and your family. It's made right here in the USA, completely non-GMO. I searched out the best quality and now have developed a double-strength form of Nascent Iodine, exclusively available at InfoWarsLife.com. Nascent Iodine is on record as one of the only safe ways to detox from fluoride poisoning. Survival Shield Nascent Iodine. Secure your super high-quality Nascent Iodine today at InfoWarsLife.com. That's InfoWarsLife.com.
See the rest of the Alex Jones Show at our sister channel, The Info Warrior, or become a member of PrisonPlanet.tv and help us take the message of freedom and liberty to the next level. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to this channel.